Hello everyone, today I'll tell you about such metal as scandium. Scandium is a rare earth metal that is located in the third group of the periodic table of chemical elements. You can find about 10 grams of scandium per ton in the earth's crust, and the richest of scandium rocks are found in Norway and Madagascar. In appearance, scandium is a shiny metal with a yellowish tint due to the scandium oxide layer covering the metal. Because of its rarity and high chemical activity, scandium has a very high price to it. This piece of scandium, weighing 1.3 grams, costs about $40. Its density is about 3 grams per cubic centimeter, only 10% more than that of aluminium. However, the melting point of scandium is much higher. Interestingly enough, scandium chips in a jar when shaken produce a very interesting sound. It's quite resonant. I can assume that this is due to the lightness and hardness of scandium. By its chemical properties, scandium resembles aluminium and lanthanides. Chips of scandium burn well in the air, and during the combustion, you can hear this interesting, raspy sound. From the heat of the reaction, the produced scandium oxide melts and forms into a ball. If you try to rub scandium into a file, you will not see scandium powder spontaneously igniting in the air. Scandium reacts well with acids, such as the hydrochloric acid. In this reaction, scandium chloride is produced. In many compounds, scandium has the oxidation state of +3. Besides acids, scandium can also react with alkali to form scandate, the complex compounds of scandium. By this characteristic, scandium is quite similar to aluminium. It has the ability to react with acids and alkalis, which means that it's amphoteric. Scandium finds many uses in the world. Scandium is often used as a dopant for the aluminium alloys. Even a simple addition of 0.4% scandium increases the strength of the alloy by 30%. Expensive bicycles are made from this alloy. Scandium iodide is added to mercury gas lamps that produce very authentic looking artificial lights, similar to the sunlight. In the nuclear industry, hydride and deuterated scandium are used for them being excellent neutron moderators. Also, scandium compounds are used for the creation of luminophores in microelectronics and in the production of solar batteries. Now you know a little bit more about one of the other metals. If you would like to support the continuous production of science videos like this one, please support channel on Patreon, link in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting videos.